You are watching Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
Here for work? Get an axe and bring me all the wood you can chop.
I came by specifically to look at her eyeballs.
Guest? Oh my.
And I found out where those eyeballs come from. Those actually come with the game. The game called Skyrim that I've been playing for all my life. And I don't know what the eyes mean, though. I'm not a lore person when it comes to vampires, but apparently there's like four different eyeballs that vampires have, depending on how hungry they are, or how recently they fed on something. So I don't know if she's recently fed on something,
you are excused,
or if she's blood-starved or what, but that's the kind of eyeballs she's got. Whatever, she's got the kind of eyeballs that she's supposed to have for whatever condition she's currently in. Because I'm looking all over for the eyeballs in my system, and I can't find the PNG file or the JPEG file. Where they use GIFs, right? No, where they use. That's the DDS file. I, for the life of me, I could not find the DDS file for that particular eyeball.
Hey, friend. It's good to see another
really?
Merry soul enjoying this fight.
You guys are gonna get murdered out here.
Share a bottle of honey.
I'm just gonna hurry up and get through this. I don't want them to die just because they saw me in the middle of the night.
Should not go unrewarded. Here, take this.
Yeah.
Cheers, my friend. May your adventure.
Okay, I needed that. So actually, it's kind of good that I ran into them.
Let's find you fame and fortune.
Okay. Because since this recording, I've made myself a vampire, and I noticed that my eyes change over time. So I don't have to panic now. If my eyes... Because before I was panicking, like, how come my vampire eyes don't look like their vampire eyes? You know? Like, what vampire mod do they have for their eyeballs that I don't have for my character? That kind of thing. But it turns out we all have the same vampire mechanic for eyeballs running. So we have the same scripts running. Part of it has to do with the dynamic vampire appearance that I'm using. So not only does it make the eyes change, it makes the face change. As you get more or less vampiric in the game, depending on what vampire mod you have installed that makes you stronger as you become more blood-starved, or if you become weaker when you become blood-starved. Apparently that's a thing on Nexus with vampire players. It's kind of a big deal if their character gets stronger or weaker as they become more and more vampire-like. And I never thought about it. You know, do you grow in strength and skill and leveling and powering and all that as the days go by and you haven't fed in a while?
You'll taste my axe. I find you.
Or, you know, does your vampire character get weaker as the days go by and you haven't fed on anyone? You know, only the MCM menu will know. Okay, it was dark out here, and we were chasing a Spriggan around, and I thought we could kill the thing at night.
Strange.
And it's nighttime, and we're not able to kill the thing. It just keeps respawning. It's not staying dead. That reminds me, I need to go into the Falkreath Hauntings mod and read the fine print. How to kill this brigand that haunts the neighborhood. So every time we would run towards the thing, kill it, it would just respawn somewhere else. And it wasn't messing with us at all. It just kind of like ignored us. Maybe it has to be fighting us first, and then we fight back, and then kill it. But if it won't fight us, then nothing's going to happen. Oh, I'm going to check right now. I'm going to go on that site right now and read it up and see what it says. Oh well, I couldn't find anything about it. Maybe it was my imagination that it had the spoilers for killing the thing at night. I want to say, since it's made of a tree, just use fire on the thing to kill it.
You'll taste my axe. Uh-oh. Did I scratch your pretty face?
But the thing is, at a certain health level, it just disappears. And then it spawns somewhere else. So maybe a slow burn is what it takes to kill the thing, so it doesn't spawn away from you right away the minute it gets damaged. Anyway, it's an interesting puzzle. I have to remember how I killed it. It comes with a nice mask that you can wear after you kill the thing. The mask is kind of creepy, if you ask me. But it was made for the Halloween time of the year. So, I want my Falkreath to be scary all year long, not just around Halloween time.
What was that?
It followed us into the tavern? What? How often does that ever happen? I'll blame script lag for that.
Victory or Solengard!
Why won't you die?
I'll gladly kill you myself.
I can take you.
I love a good fight.
I won't go down so easily.
Oh, that sounded like, what's her face? Arisa? Why am I videotaping in the dark again? Driscoll, what are you doing? Can't see squat. Running around like a mad person. I thought I knew where I was going. I mean, I knew where I was going, but I just didn't know how to get there. Mickey has the torch, but she's just too...
When I find you, you're dead.
She's too dang far away.
Where are you?
And then the ghost here in the cemetery, she's part of the Falkreath Hauntings. I don't know what her story is. So anyway, today I went to KFC, Kentucky Fried Chicken, got the $5 fill-up. Guess what? The food is such small portions now. On the commercials, you can kind of tell that the food is tiny. But they have the camera way up close on the food, so it looks like regular size. But yeah, so... I mean, when I was a kid, $5 got you a lot of chicken from KFC. Now, you're lucky if I ate the stupid $5 fill-up thing, and 2 minutes later, I was still hungry. like the bowl of mashed potatoes and gravy comes in a little pill box. That's what it is. A little pill box. Used to come in a bowl. I don't think it can be killed. Why was I even trying this?
There you are. Damn you.
The thing was just everywhere.
You're as good as dead.
But there were some bandits out here as well, so.
Show me how brave you are. Shoot him. I'll smash his head.
This is over.
I'm not afraid of you.
So every time I glow, that's my race doing that. My dark elf race. That's my spidey sense, my tingly spidey sense.
Never should have come here.
You leave him alone.
I don't know how we're gonna kill the thing. I'm gonna have to go do some more research. Because the minute I touch the thing with an arrow, it just respawns somewhere else.
What was that?
Yeah! I'm almost... Oh! Did I die?
This is rather exciting.
I don't remember getting killed by that stupid thing. Anyway.
Good to see you. Teach them to stop paying me.
Yep, yep.
Here, you deserve a reward for your service. You know what? I like you. You're not afraid to get your hands dirty. I hereby grant you permission to purchase property in Falkreath Hold. Talk to my steward if you're interested.
And I actually did buy property.
There is room in my court for a new thane. It's an honorary title mainly, but there are a few perks someone like you could make use of. However, I could only grant the title to someone who is known throughout my hold. You help my people, and I'll make you my thane. On your way, then.
Yeah, so in my current playthrough, I'm going to build a house.
Later, then.
The one that overlooks the lake.
The Legion's always looking for strong, capable warriors.
And,
you think you've got what it takes. Our headquarters is in Solitude.
I'm not using any mods for it. So I'm going to have to hunt down all the items from Home Depot so I can build a house.
Going now?
Another playthroughs years ago, I used to just have the chest full of all the stuff I needed to make a house. So I wouldn't have to go anywhere or buy anything to build the house with. Okay, so the prostitute here, she's got purple socks on. There's no purple in my game. So I thought I'd exit out, see if I could fix her purplish. Nope.
Yes?
She's still got purple going
all
on.
All right, then.
She's using beast skeleton. So she's got beast boots on. And it's missing textures for one of the ankles. For one of the feet.
You're doing a fine job around here.
Thank you, sir.
And,
don't let my brother...
That was bugging me. That was really, really bugging me that she had purple meshes with no textures. I hate when my game has purple meshes.
What a lovely morning.
So the UNP armors is not compatible with the beast skeleton that I'm using.
I think you might be in the wrong place, friend.
But I want to use the UNP armors. So what I had to do was I came indoors.
Hello again, friend. I'll never forget what you did for me.
See if there's any other beasts in here with purple socks.
I hear Valder made it back safe.
Too bad about the others, but at least it's one less thing to worry about.
Okay, so the quest did not break. Because I found this guy out in...
Gossip in town? Be sure to share it with
I found him before she had mentioned he was missing. So once I removed the beast skeleton and just went to vanilla for the Argonians and for the Khajiits, guess what?
Hey, you there.
The missing textures went away.
Mm-hmm.
So now she's got human skeleton and her purple ankles are no more.
I hope you will find a warmer welcome in your travels than we have found in ours.
So she's got human feet and human legs before she had the beast legs and the beast feet, which come with beast shoes. And it's the beast shoes that use vanilla textures that were jacked up because
yes.
I no longer have vanilla textures.
Mm-hmm. Yes. All right, then.
Anyway, I still have the thing with the that Stentor lady at the Blue Palace. She has missing ankles. So, I don't know what's worse. Purple ankles or no ankles?